Bach's setting of the St. John Passion was the first really extensive work of its type, and it emerged from the tradition of singing the story of the crucifixion and the days leading up to it, which was established in the Roman Catholic Church and then evolved through the Lutheran Church, through the writing of Schütz, into these orchestral masterpieces, St. John Passion, and after that the Matthew Passion by Bach. The Schütz St. Matthew Passion is extremely dry, rather fine, but extremely dry piece of writing for choir unaccompanied. The Bach Passions are full of the greatest of Bach's music, based on the writings of his 200 or so cantatas and expanded through to a two-hour-long work telling the story of the trial of Jesus and the eventual death of Jesus. The construction of the Passions of Bach are on various levels. In a sense, cementing them together, we have the chorales, which would be congregational hymns sung by the congregation in St. Thomas's Church in Leipzig. And then around the chorales, you have the narration told by the evangelist and involving the drama of the story. The characters other than Jesus, of course, we have the Christ, Christus, we have Pontius Pilate, we have various servants and maids and people like that who were sort of part of the drama. At the same time, the chorus enacts the drama by relating the usually hysterical cries from the crowd, crucify him, he is a malefactor and all the rest of it. We end up with three levels of performance. We have the story being told by the evangelist and the characters, and the chorus acting as the angry crowd, and you have the reflective levels reflecting on the state of the drama, where the drama's got to in the arias and the other choruses, and you have the whole thing bound together by the congregational hymns, the chorales. One can get bogged down looking at the technical way that Bach has compiled his Passions. The simple fact is, for any audience goer, that the music is absolutely astonishingly fine. The best that Bach wrote. It's complemented in the cantatas, but the St. John Passion and the St. Matthew Passion that followed it, and then the B minor Mass, are three of the great pinnacles of choral writing, of sacred writing from Western civilization. Coincidentally, the Royal Choral Society has a special relationship with the St. John Passion. It was first conducted in the United Kingdom by Joseph Barnby in 1872, at the time that he also became music director of the Royal Albert Hall Choral Society, the predecessor by name of what is now the Royal Choral Society.